Hello. Remember the last time you slept for good 8 hours? Me neither. Because India is the second most sleep-deprived country after Japan. What's stopping us? Is it a show that you are hooked to and want to finish one last episode before you go to bed? Or maybe it's the multiplayer video game and you just have one more mission to fulfill? Or just a long day at work and all that extra caffeine you have been sipping? Whatever may be the reason, if you too have been feeling more tired, drained and exhausted from long day and could probably sleep for a week, if you got the chance, then yes, you are sleep deprived, just like 93% of Indians.
So, uth jaag musafir bhor bahi, ab rain kahan jo sovat hai so khovat hai, jo jagat hai so pavat hai.
There are many proverbs like this that says that sleeping is a waste of time. People say that sleep is overrated. An average adult sleeps 6.8 hours a night. In Japan, the average hour is 5 hours 59 minutes. And in India, this average is 6 hours and 20 minutes. Enough? No. An average adult needs at least 7 to 8 hours of sleep every night. What about the other age groups? Newborns need to sleep between 14 to 17 hours a day. Between the ages of 3 and 5, the recommended sleep hour is between 10 to 13 hours. Between 14 to 17 years of age, it's 8 to 10 hours. A study suggests that 72% of Indians wake up 1 to 3 times per night, and 87% of them feel that lack of sleep is affecting their health. When we sleep, our body heals. There are three realms of sleep we go through, which is necessary to keep our brain and heart functioning, to process all the information we have gathered throughout the day. Also, you cannot make up for your lack of sleep throughout the week by sleeping on weekends. Neither sleeping any time of the day will help. People are sleepiest in the afternoon between 1 p.m. to 3 p.m. and between 2 a.m. and 4 a.m. This is something that should not be ignored. Why? Because sleep deprivation leads to drastic drop in health, both mental and physical, and productivity level. Let's talk about health first. Cardiovascular disease, diabetes, hypertension, stroke, weight gain, memory loss. These are just some negative impacts of sleep deprivation. Lack of sleep is also linked to cancer. Researchers have shown that disruption in the body's biological clock, which controls sleep and thousands of other functions, may raise the odds of breast cancers, colon, ovaries, and prostate cancer too. We all work in shifts these days. It goes without saying that night shifts are the hardest, and it's extremely bad for your health too. Exposure to light while working overnight shifts for several years may reduce levels of melatonin, encouraging cancer to grow. A British research report says that lack of sleep doubles the risk of death from cardiovascular disease for those who cut their sleep 7 to 5 or fewer hours at night. If this sounds too far-fetched to you, look at this news. There's a term in Japan for death that happens because of lack of sleep. It's called karoshi. What about mental health? Lack of sleep leads to anxiety and depression. It even impairs your ability to judge, ability to interpret events. Now, let's come to productivity. We have all had one of those days in office where we just want to go back home and sleep. It becomes difficult for you to concentrate at work. Without adequate sleep, employees have more difficulty learning and communicating. Memory lapses increase, problem-solving abilities decline. There is a report that says that an estimate of a whopping $60 billion is lost by US companies because of poor productivity due to lack of sleep. On an annual basis, the US loses an equivalent of around 1.2 million working days due to insufficient sleep. So when a working day is lost, a company loses money, countries, GDP take a hit. The only industry that profits from your insomnia is the marketing industry selling sleep. From candles, music to apps, sleep has become a product, and the industry selling this is worth $10.9 billion, and this market is expected to grow 16% in the next 5 years. So do yourself a favor, sleep well, because it's the only way your brain and body will remain fit enough to watch that show play that game and perform better at work tomorrow.